Hi guys, it's Gaz from PMTV UK here again, and today we're going to be checking out 5 of the best keyboard arranger workstations going. For those of you who don't know what a keyboard arranger workstation is, it's essentially a keyboard that's got everything inside of it. So sounds, sequencer, so making your own song from scratch, the capability to manipulate and edit your parameters, different effects, sampling, and of course screens to see where you're going with everything. So in effect, it is a whole workstation. It's almost like a portable studio, if you will. This is the Roland FA06. You have modulation control on here and a pitch bend, which is pretty awesome. You also have the Roland D-Beam as well, which those of you who have used it, you'll know it's awesome. If you haven't, it allows you to do lots of cool little things just by moving your hand. You can change volume levels. You can even do a solo synth on this thing with it as well, which is pretty cool. Then we have all of our rotaries here. As you can see, we've got control over cutoff, resonance, stack, release, pan, level. So all your basic kind of like synth parameters. And we also have different effect control, EQ, and other sort of global controls as well. So everything's at the touch and ready to hand. So that digital workstation control will give you control over transports. So you've got your transports here. It will give you control over your effects, MIDI controlling, so controlling reverbs, delays, etc. and things like that. And just make your life a little bit easier and your workflow that bit more simplified, allowing you to, well, enjoy your music more. Obviously split and dual, so you can like have dual sounds, or you can split your keyboard across and layer and things like that. Octave up and octave down and transpose, because this is a 61 note keyboard. You might need to transpose up and down to get to your relative octaves or what have you. We have a lovely bright display here where you can see everything that's going on from the preset that you're on right the way through to sequencing abilities. So you can see all of your different instruments across here on your different MIDI channels, where they're positioned in terms of your loops and sequencing position as well. So it's really handy and really clear to have this here. Really speeds up your workflow, etc. Obviously your presets are down here, so you have all your different banks of presets and different sounds as well, so piano and electric piano, keyboard and organ, so to keep everything relevant together, so you don't have to kind of worry about switching into a different kind of a bank that's not relevant to the sound you're looking for. On the final section across here, this is our kind of like performance and sampler kind of area here. We have an arpeggio. So we can select arpeggios, we have chord memory as well, and we have rhythm patterns where you can select different like kind of drum patterns and things like that. You can set on the arpeggio, you can set what type of arpeggio it is, so you can completely change the sound of it up into like shuffle rate, accent rate, octave range and things like that. So it is really, really in-depth and intuitive. And again, the rhythm pattern as well will allow you to simply select drums. So for example, and you can have those going along through your whole song. Pressing it again will stop it. So again, really easy and straightforward to get rhythm tracks going. As I mentioned earlier, if we press the sequencer button, it takes us into sequencer mode, where we can go through all of our different tracks and edit where they are inside of our songs, create loops and change the instrument for each MIDI track essentially. We also have the loop mode and song select, where we can select our song from a list, so you can save your own songs inside of here and go back to them at a later date for performance and recording. And finally, the sampler. Now the sampler on the FA series is really cool. Roland have always been good in terms of sampling and drum sounds and being able to chop things up, you know, the SPDSX, Octopad, and indeed the IRA range of samplers that they've got there are really easy to use and are ideal for chopping up stuff on the go. The same kind of goes with the Roland FA06 here. A quick look at the ins and outs of the FA series. It's exactly the same that's on the FA and the A06, so you're not missing out in terms of ins and outs. We have a line input, and we also have two different types of inputs here for mic and for guitar. which is something you don't see often on a range of workstations, is a high Z input. We then have control over foot pedal control, hold, and standard MIDI in and out for connecting to other studio equipment and effects engines. So in terms of ins and outs, this keyboard is more than capable of handling anything you want to throw at it. Also, a quick look at the FA08. So the main difference between the FA08 and the FA06 is that this is a full graded weighted action keyboard, as opposed to the semi-weighted velocity sensitive FA06. So if your main kind of instrument is piano and you're primarily focused on having a really nice weighted action, then the FA08 would be more suitable for you. It is a fair bit larger, as you can see, and it is considerably heavier as well, but this is all owing to the account that it's got a premium grade weighted action keyboard inside of it, and you'd expect the build quality to be this good and for it to be that heavy, to be honest with you. So obviously the thing that everybody wants to know, from the features and the functionality the keyboards have, is how good are the sounds? They're awesome, in my personal opinion. I love them. They feature the Supernatural sound engine, which means that it's got sounds from the Integra, it's PCM sounds as well, so everything from high-grade pianos to luscious synths, so stuff from the Jupiter range, the SH range, so vintage classic synths, and also a bit of a modern twist on them as well. Really cool. So I only briefly mentioned the sampler before, and that's because it's got quite a lot of potential and usability, essentially. So it's not only a sampler that you can use to trigger things, you can actually use the sampler to record things like guitar or other drum machines or microphone or anything like that that's coming in. So you can be jamming along with your friend who's maybe playing some nice blues licks. You can record that into the sampler and build up a song that way and incorporate external instruments. It's a really fun way to get other people involved and to get jamming and to connect other gear up as well. It also includes a fantastic effects engine, so you can put effects on tracks. You can put effects on the master channel as well, so you can get cool little filter effects, reverb effects and stuff that allow you to get your transitions between intros, verses, choruses, etc. sounding that much better and that bit more professional. So although we've covered some of my favourite features of these keyboards, I always do stress that it's important to actually get down to one of your local PMT stores and get your hands on it and see how it feels, listen to the sounds and decide whether that's right for you. We are located up and down the country, so we're never far away from you. And we've always got experts on hand who are more than happy to guide you through everything to do with the keyboards and make sure we get the correct product for you. Now we're going to be looking at the amazing Korg Chrome. Killer name, killer product. So the gorgeous Korg Chromes are the successor to what was one of the most popular keyboards in the world, the Korg M50. And they retain some of the fantastic features and sounds and really build on that and have crafted, in my opinion, one of the best workstation keyboards bang for buck that you can buy. So the Korg Chrome comes in three different versions. It comes in a semi-weighted 61 key, semi-weighted 73 key, and a full hammer action Korg Chrome 88. So on the left hand side, as you would expect, you have a pitch and a mod kind of wheel joystick controller thing here, which I really like. It's one of my favorite features on Korg keyboards. I find it really easy to use, and it's awesome for both manipulating and editing the pitch and modulation at the same time. Awesome. Again, we have volume control. We have very simplified section here for tonal options, for user settings, and for like controlling your own user parameters. We have an arpeggiator section on here as well. We have a lovely responsive touchscreen here. As you can see, the input delay is little to non-existent. It's really quick to set it up. Everything's responsive, and it feels really nice to use as well. You know, they've put a lot of effort into making sure that this is intuitive and doesn't impede or hinder on a more traditional workflow or way of making music, so to speak. So So you can use the touchscreen to get to wherever you want, but the buttons will also correspond as well. So you can use the button to exit different menus and things like that as well. There's also the little scroll wheel on here, so this will get you through your different presets and different parameters and things very quickly. Finally, on the right hand side here, we have our different settings. So we have combi setting. So the combi setting, as you can see on the screen here, allows you to essentially set up a multi-timbral group of instruments. So you can have strings, synthesizers, drums, keyboards, pianos, all going at one time, layered, dual, split, whatever you want, essentially. It gives you full control over that. So from combi we go to program mode. Now program mode is the individual sounds themselves, so your drums, your synths and things, it's all just one instrument without any kind of layering going on and stuff like that, really one program as such. And then you have your sequencer on here. The sequencer will take you to the sequencing section where you can choose your song, you can choose your MIDI tracks. You can choose everything what's going on inside of your mix. You can control the levels of everything here as well. And as I say, you can just use your touchscreen to control it. It's really easy, really straightforward. And the wheel also works for controlling that as well. So as you see, as I go through the touchscreen, it's really seamless and easy to use. So we also have bank mode. So you can use bank mode to load up different combinations of sounds. So if you're doing a live set or what have you, you can quickly choose between different banks. You can also use the numbers here and enter to enter you onto different presets within those banks as well. And we also have sequencer control here. So we can use this to start and stop and record, as you see, anything that we input into the keyboard and anything we play into the keyboard. So really straightforward. So the sounds in the Korg Chrome are killer. There's 3.8 gigabytes of memory, and that contains some of their own presets, some of it's from some of their most loved synthesizers. It contains a piano that's derived from the Korg Kronos, which a lot of you will know is their flagship model, and it's absolutely awesome. So to have that quality of piano in a keyboard that's on this budget is second to none, really. There's also a fantastic drum kit derived from the Kronos as well inside of here. And as I say, various other sounds from the most vintage and loved synthesizers, all of which are accessible via the handy control screen here. And you can edit all of the parameters just by the touch of your hand, really. It's awesome. So just to show you how easy and simple it is to go through your different sounds and find presets that you enjoy, you simply hit the program, you hit the category mode, and then you can go inside of here and you can just quickly. And you see how quick it is to load? No sitting around waiting for sounds to load, no awkward VST crashes. Everything's just there and ready to work. So the Korg Chrome can be used to create a track from scratch, essentially. You can do everything you need to inside of here, but there is USB capability to take it into your computer and further refine your mixes or do your mastering inside of the computer. You can also control various workstations, MIDI in and out, all of that other cool stuff for integration with existing setups. So those are some of my favourite features of the Korg Chromes. And next up we'll have the lovely Yamaha MX-49 in blue edition. I love this keyboard because it's lightweight, it weighs absolutely nothing, really portable, and the sounds on it are fantastic. Let's take a little look. I did mention that the sounds were fantastic on the MX range, and I wasn't lying. They're directly derived from the Yamaha Motif XS series, so they're some of the most prominent and popular sounds in contemporary music located within this keyboard itself. One of the most impressive features about this keyboard is its massive polyphony, 128 voice polyphony, meaning that you're not going to get any dropouts when you're performing live or if you're under pressure in the studio. It also has a fantastic 16-track sequencer inside of it too. So the Motif sound engine inside of the MX series allows you to modulate, layer, and kind of mess around with up to 8 elements of each voice. So you've got a lot of tonal control, a lot of creativity, and some fantastic sounds to boot. So on the left-hand side, we have lovely feeling, modulation, and pitch wheels here. Obviously, they can be assigned to control pitch variations and any kind of modulation on the keyboard. So for bringing in filters and vibrato, tremolo, that kind of stuff. Simple volume, master knob control on here. Really easy to see, set it aside so that if you're playing live, you won't knock it out of the way when you're trying to edit any settings or load up different sounds, which is really cool. As is standard across most workstation keyboards, you have 4 controllers on here, which allow you to control various different parameters and elements of your sounds, songs, and things like that as well. So effects, synthesizer, parameters, volumes, pans, and you can even assign your own on there. All of them really easy to use just by pushing this knob function button on here. There's the digital workstation remote as well. So if you press that, it will turn itself into almost like a MIDI mode if you've got it connected up to the computer, and you can control various workstations, primarily Cubase, with this keyboard, which allows further integration in the studio. The whole idea behind the MX-49, as you can see, is it's very much stripped back. It's a pick-up and go kind of keyboard, in my personal opinion. The screen is a lot smaller on this one, so it's very small. It is kind of driven by hand controls on here, so there will be very little scrolling through a menu type of stuff. On this keyboard, it is more focused on hands-on, but the little screen does certainly help you navigate where you're going through presets, saving presets, all that kind of stuff as well. So the performance number will let you know what performance you're on. So a performance could be a whole section of sounds, like almost like a full song. And you can select through these, scroll through them just like that. So the little rotary controller here will allow you to go through all your different presets, so keyboard, and allow you to scan through all your different keyboard presets, so on and so forth. Little arrows for controlling where you're going, so for going to presets, for moving up and down through different patches, so put a rock on there, change the synth sound. So it's really easy to combine sounds and straightforward as well. And finally on the right, we have all of our control for VST control, for MIDI control, and for actual control over the banks and patches itself on the keyboard here. So we have layer and split. Obviously they mean you can split and layer various sounds across the keyboard, so different keys can trigger different elements of your sounds. And we have an arpeggiator on there as well. We have rhythm pattern, so obviously we have some quality drum sounds on there, as you've heard. And we also have external song for you connecting up your USB stick with MIDI and audio data, etc. We then, very quickly, we have our categories on here. So very easy, as I say, straightforward, to the point. If you want brass, you hit brass. If you want strings, you hit strings. You get the point on there. Very easy to use. So the keyboard itself, as I say, is designed to be minimal, less fuss, less hassle, and just kind of get on with it and enjoy making your music. really cool features of the MX series is the fact that it includes VCM, which is virtual circuit modeling, which allows them to get that old school vintage synthesizer kind of warm sound into digital gear. It sounds really responsive and accurate. There's loads of bundled software that comes with it. So you've got Cubase, you've got Steinberg Prolog, and you've got some other various Yamaha goodies. On top of that, there are other sound sets and samples and things that you can pop onto this via USB. There is an auxiliary in for you to record in other things and kind of mess around with external sound sources too. The MX does come in other sizes, so 61 and 88. However, I really enjoy the 49 for its ability just to be able to pack it in a bag and off you go with it. You know, premium, professional quality, usable sounds at an affordable price, with minimal footprint as well. Give it a little shot, come and play it, get hands on with it, and decide whether that's what you want. And up next we have the beautiful Korg Kronos. Just look at this thing, it's amazing. Lovely finish, metal finish on the top of it, and a lovely vintage kind of wood finish on the side. It looks absolutely fantastic, and it sounds even better. So the Kronos is Korg's flagship synthesizer model. It features some of the nicest sounding pianos, synthesizers, keyboards, drums, combined with some of the most powerful capabilities for crafting and creating a signature sound that I've ever seen. It really is an all-in-one workstation that does everything. So the Korg Kronos contains some of the most original, amazing sounds from the previous range of their products, you know, sounds that you will all know and love. So very quickly, on the left hand side here, we have obviously a traditional Korg joystick here, which, as I've said in a previous video, I actually really enjoy. It's probably my favourite joystick for pitch and modulation control out there. We also have a joystick controller here for editing different kind of like settings inside a Karma and for changing your sound up a little bit more. We'll go into the Karma engine in a little bit more detail later. We have a main volume control here, and then we have the different Karma switches, so on or off, latch, module control, and we also have a drum track button for inserting rhythm patterns whenever we're good to go. So we could hit drum track there and go. So in an instant, you can get a nice fat sound and have some drums to jam along with, which is really handy if you are starting to build a song from scratch. Various other controls on here as well. So we have audio control, we can choose along here as well. We have external control, we have the more control knobs for the Karma engine, and we have tone adjustment and EQ control via here as well. We also have the timbre and the track as well. And all of these LED, all of these switches light up as well, so you can see exactly where you're going in a dark environment. Across the top, we also have control over our different parameters for cutoffs, resonance, all that kind of synthy stuff combined with EQing and other user modes on there as well. And we also have mix volumes here as well for our Karma control. So everything is literally to your hand. Moving on, we have this lovely sort of like almost a high definition screen here. It looks fantastic, and there's no input or latency lag or anything like that. I can switch through and it takes me no time at all to do so. This, combined with the fact that you are hands-on with the controls, the faders, and the rotaries on here, means that you get the best of both worlds, you know? If you're far more comfortable using a touchscreen to do everything, then do so. But you do have the capability to control your Karma and your actual performance on here as well. And on the right-hand side, you have your various banks, sounds, sequencer options, all that kind of stuff as well, where you can go through your combinations, your programs, your sequencer, all this kind of stuff. And as you can see, the screen is incredibly detailed, high definition. You can go and edit every single part that you want to. So it really is straightforward and easy. There's also plenty of options for checking the internal drive, which by the way is incredibly fast. So because the sounds are that great a quality in this, you would expect a traditional kind of like hard drive to struggle loading the sounds. It would take a lot longer. So there is an ultra fast drive in here that allows you to load all of these high quality sounds in seconds, you know. It really is handy. And obviously you have a disc control on here as well, where you can see all of your sound data. You can open everything up and you can sort everything out on it as well. So in terms of keeping everything ordered and keeping everything kind of set and, you know, orderly, I guess, you can do that via the screen with the disc. Kronos, as I say, is incredibly feature rich, and you've got options for just about everything on here. Full control over everything, your multis, your midis, so connecting up to external gear, making sure your clock's sorted out, audio network as well. So it really is an all-in-one controller. So the Korg Kronos comes in three different versions. It comes in a semi-weighted 61 key version, which is this one here. We have a weighted 73 key version, and we have a weighted 88 key version as well. So if you do prefer a piano action and more of a weighted feel, you can go for one of the other models and you will get that exactly. The Karma engine essentially allows you to generate MIDI data and kind of chop up your performance, and just helps you get a little bit more creative with things really without you having to input much data. So let's turn the Karma engine on. And let's combine that with like a drum track as well. So let's pop a drum track on there and see where we go. So essentially with the Karma engine, whatever you put into it, it'll read it and it'll feed you something back that fits with what you're doing essentially. Think of it as a little bit of a friend or a helping hand if you want to get a nice little jam on the go essentially. Awesome. Without going into too much depth and taking all day with it, the Karma engine is a lot more and you can do a lot more with it, and I advise coming down and getting hands on so we can show you exactly what it's capable of in person. So it's worth noting that the Korg Kronos does have the fantastic SGX2 piano engine inside of it, which gives it that massive sound and that natural kind of like ambience to it, so to speak. It really is lovely. There are also 9 dedicated sound engines inside of the Kronos, which kind of like smashes all the other competition out of the way in terms of getting a sound that you want quickly. There are also 16 studio premium quality effects processors inside of the Kronos, so it's not just about the sound of the instruments, the actual sound quality of the effects is second to none as well. This will save you hassle of having to take effects units out with you if you perform live, or having to run it through various VSTs when you connect it up to the computer and things. You really can get a finished product inside of the box with the Kronos. We have lots of ins and outs, your standard stereo connection there, although you can use a mono connection. You have your various pedal inputs and outputs as well. You have optical SPDIF in and out as well. You have a microphone and a line level input on there, a MIDI in and out and a through, which is really handy for connecting to other MIDI related gear. And you have obviously your power, and you have your USBs on there as well for connecting, you know, like USB drives with external sound packs, MIDI files, audio files, you name it, and for backing up and saving data as well. So I literally have just scraped the surface with this Kronos. There is so much detail and so much to learn and to use. inside the product, that's I feel like it's impossible to cover it in such a short period of time, and it wouldn't do it justice. So what I would advise is to come down and chat to one of your local experts at the PMT store. So up next, we have the lovely Yamaha Montage. We're going to be looking at the Montage 6 here today. However, they do a Montage 7 and an 8, and the 8 is fully weighted action. So the Montage range of keyboards by Yamaha is essentially, as some people are putting it, the future of synthesis. So it allows you to have fantastic modern sounding engines whilst being able to retain the tonal characteristics of previous synthesizers. So the motif range, even the DX synthesis kind of range on there as well. So there's a lot of FM synthesis potential inside of here, as well as some more current contemporary sounds. You can do everything from programming algorithms of FM synthesis. So if you're a big fan of old school FM synthesis sounds, you can do that. Combine it with the more recent sound engines and get yourself some nice lead synths, some strings behind it and things like that as well. So you can combine modern sounds with old school FM kind of sounds as well, which will very much appeal to those synthesizer lovers. On top of that, you can take some older sounds from Yamaha's previous versions, so like motifs and, as I say, DX sounds, and actually import them into the Montage range of keyboards as well. So Yamaha have understood that a lot of people who might be very keen on their older sounds and don't want to upgrade to a Montage because they're afraid of losing everything that they've done, they're quite keen on making sure that those people are, you know, kind of looked after essentially, and that you can take your favorite sounds from previous keyboards into this one. So it really is awesome at combining old school and new school. So standard Yamaha pitch and mod with a ribbon on here as well, different assignable buttons here, and also these can relate to the motion control stuff on here, which we'll go into in a little bit more detail as well. Across the top we have, and highly visible as well may I add, controls for basic synthesis and like kind of like envelope parameters on there. We have EQ selection on there as well, effects, and we have control over the Montage's like engine as it were. So as you'll see, there are a lot of LEDs and rotaries and faders on here. This is just to give you more control hands-on over your performance or over your recording essentially. We'll go into this in a little bit more detail too. So this big flashing beacon of light here is what we call the super knob. Now the super knob allows you to change between elements, between effects, between instruments, and kind of blend in sounds together, and it's really quite unique. Now obviously we've all, you know, only got a limited amount of fingers and hands available. However, what you can do is you can plug an expression pedal in, like I've done here, and you can use the expression pedal to control some of the super knob's parameters, which again just leaves your hands free to do everything else. We then have our transport controls on here, and our octave up and our octave down, because this is the 61 version of the keyboard, so it is smaller. Moving on, we have the fantastic touchscreen here, which is full color and displays everything that goes on under the hood of the keyboard, so to speak. Now, you do also on the right hand side have controls that directly correlate to the touchscreen here, so it isn't just, you don't have to just press that. If you want a more traditional approach of using buttons, you can use buttons for the vast majority of things inside of here as well. The touchscreen does allow you to go into much more detail, and as you can see, the input is, there's no lag, no latency between it. It's really fast and it's not going to hinder your workflow. So they have put a lot of effort into making this really intuitive and, you know, quick to use. We'll be right back. massive 128 note polyphony also means that you're going to really struggle to push this thing to its maximum when you're playing live or when you're in the studio, which means that you're going to have jitter-free performance. There's nothing that's going to be cutting out, and there's nothing that's going to be too intense for the keyboard. So you can arrange your live performances into sets called live sets there, where you can go back and forward between all of your favorite sets, and it takes you no time at all to get there. So if you've got a whole performance to do, you know, if you're out performing at a gig, you can just choose all of your different live sets on there. Take seconds to load the live sets in and you're good to go. You can also edit all of these live sets on the go. You can go into more detail. So once you've saved a live set, it's not necessarily the end of the world and you have to start again. You can go and you can re-edit anything whenever you want. So just to show you what the motion sequencing is capable of, it allows you to take one sound, use the expression, bring in all of our other synths. We can then use these sliders control the different parts of our performance. So the screen is fundamentally used for building algorithms for your FM synthesis, for your mixing. So for example, we can set mutes, solos, we can set levels, panning, we can set the amount of send that is going to our effects engines, all of that kind of stuff. We can also use this to control our motion control, to change what the super knob does, triggering, all of that kind of stuff as well. And we can also use it as a base to record our audio patterns and things. So the montage will connect to a computer perfectly as well, and you can actually stream your audio and MIDI files via USB, meaning that it is perfect for adding into a studio or for getting yourself a premium keyboard to start your studio with, essentially. So another really cool feature that I love about the montage and just allows you to integrate it with external gear like drum machines is the audio input. So you can actually set an envelope follower so that you can have the envelope controlling things like effects and things like that, but directly from the source of the drum machine. So you could have a rhythm pattern dictating how an effect envelope is crafted and kind of like performs, essentially. So aside from the FM synthesis engine, it features the AWM2 engine, which allows for incredibly high quality, high fidelity audio files to be put onto the keyboard without sacrificing sound quality through compression, essentially. So you get fantastic sounding presets and instruments without sacrificing on, you know, space and compression. Sequencing, it offers 16 sequencing tracks with real-time overdub, overlay, all that kind of stuff. So on the go, you can record with it. You don't have to be connected to an audio interface. You don't have to have thousands of VSTs loaded up, all these different plugins and things. The montage is more than capable of handling any need and requirement that you need for it in the studio and live as well. There's a big debate on the moment as to whether the montage is better than the Kronos or whether the Kronos is better than the montage. To be honest with you, it's a really subjective question at the end of the day, and it's really down to the user. They're both fantastic workstation keyboards, and I honestly couldn't pick one of them that was better than the other. I think that they're suitable for the same needs, but also for different needs at the same time. And I think the only way to kind of figure out that shootout is to come down and try it yourself, really. Essentially, if you own previous Yamaha products from the Motif range, or if you are a big fan of DX synthesis, FM stuff, and you want to get into sort of more modern technology and kind of have something that allows you to connect up to a studio and use live, the Montage is going to be an ideal choice for you. It's going to mean that you're not going to have to lose all of your sounds that you love from previous generations of keyboards, but it also gives you the ability to get a more modern sound and kind of combine old school and new school together. Of course, it doesn't just cover synthesis. The piano engine inside of it, the guitars, the basses, the strings, all of your sort of classical contemporary instruments, they all sound fantastic through the Montage as well. When you combine it with some of the studio quality effects that they've got going on, the motion sequencing engine, it's kind of a no-brainer for anyone who really wants a fantastic integrated workstation keyboard. So that's some of the key features of the Montage 6, particularly the features that I feel set it apart from the rest of the workstation keyboards out there. As always, I feel like the best way for you to figure out whether this is right for you is to pop into one of your stores. Luckily for you, we are from south to north, London to Newcastle, so we're never far away from you. In all of our stores, we have resident tech experts like myself who'll be able to guide you all the way through the product and make sure that it is the correct one for you. So there we have it. There's five of some of the best keyboard arranger workstations going at the moment. Of course, it is entirely subjective as to which is the best, and I'm sure all of you have your opinion on that. If you feel like there's a synthesizer that we've missed or something that you want us to cover, or that there's a better synthesizer than any of these for doing the job, please do let us know in the comments section. Other than that, if you want to check out any of the other videos that we've got, please do check out the rest of the PMTV YouTube channel. We also have Facebook for all of your local stores, Instagram and Twitter. Those get updated daily, so please do check back there for recent content. Other than that, thank you for taking the time to watch. I've been Gaz, you've been you. Cheers.